Hey everybody. So today I'm going to be going over what exactly I have right now in my get home bag. And I'm going to talk a little bit about sort of my philosophy on get home bags. And this is also sort of like a part two to a separate video that I did. The first video I did where I actually went out and I tested all of this. And so this is sort of a follow up to that where I'm explaining my thoughts, how everything worked out. Yeah. So, first of all, this is the bag I used. You're going to notice that the first part of my philosophy with this is to not spend a lot of money. So, a lot of this gear is gear that I have anyways because of my duties with the National Guard. So, sorry Sergeant Hale if you're watching this. So this is the assault pack, Army issue. It's definitely not the best thing out there when you're trying to think of weight. But like I said, price is also a consideration here, so I went with what I had. So the other main thing I brought was the poncho. This is sort of what made up my shelter while I was testing out this bag. That's sort of the idea behind it. So, I have it set up right now. You can see I've got 550 cord already set up in different rings here. And the whole idea is that it's ready to go as an emergency shelter, a plot point shelter. And as far as how that went, it worked pretty well. It was nice and low profile. It probably wasn't the best option if I were to have a fire, but the idea behind this kit doesn't really include having a big fire, at least not as it is right now. This is sort of a get home as quickly and safely as you can sort of bag. And you know, if you have to spend one or two nights outside on your way home, then you know this will get you through, especially in the warmer months. I think it might be a good idea to try and cater the bag to the season that you're in. Right now it is July here in Virginia, so it's pretty warm. Next thing I have here is my canteen and canteen holder. So this is great. You know, carries water. You can boil water in this part. Fit together, good to go. Now I also have this water filtration system. This is, I believe, the Sawyer Mini is what it's called. So, sort of like a Life Straw, I guess it's like the off-brand or something. I got this for, you know, Christmas or something a few years ago, and I tested it out. I didn't get sick, and I was testing it out on some pretty stagnant and murky water, so. It works. The idea behind that is that, you know, you don't always have time to stop and make a fire and boil water to safely drink it. If you're trying to get home as quickly and safely as possible, this is very useful. You can just stop and get water as you go and then just keep moving. Next up, $1 flashlight from Walmart. It works. Are there better flashlight options out there? Of course. But for $1, yeah, that's what you get. It works. I have here two lighters. Two big lighters. Can't tell I am back home in my backyard. But yeah, the two lighters, I mean, that's just the most efficient and secure way to ensure you can get a fire going if you need to. Along with that, a little bottle of hand sanitizer. Sort of a hot commodity these days, I guess. But this little bottle is perfect. It can be used for sanitation purposes, but it's also a great fire starter. You just put that on some kindling, put the flame from a lighter to it, and it'll catch and it'll go. you'll have a fire going. I have here Cuba Chapstick. That's just somewhat of a comfort item, I suppose. I'm sure it has other survival uses, but it's something that I like to have. Knife. This is, I think, like a $10 knife from Walmart. Once again, focusing on keeping everything cheap. but, you know, it works. I haven't had any major issues with it. Once again, are there better options out there? Of course. But this is what I got. Small roll of toilet paper, just in case. I have here a few cheap, flimsy tent stakes that I pulled from a tent that I got separately. These are great for pinning down your shelter. You don't want to be out there trying to make stakes when you're in a hurry or you're trying to get home. So having these super light little things is great. They're cheap. They're not very sturdy. That's why I have six instead of the three that I need, just in case any of them break or bend or anything. Additionally, I have two packets of tea, just in case. They weigh nothing, so why not? I have here a pillow, definitely just a comfort item, but it does take up a lot of space, but it is something that I personally find I need in order to even get just a few hours of sleep. Of course, if it's the winter time, you know, I can use my jacket as a pillow, but in summer, I won't have a jacket on me, so I have that. And I have this big, fat, giant sleeping bag right here. This thing took up so much space in the pack. It is heavy. It's just a beast. It's really more to keep me off the ground, keep me out of the leaves. And if it does, if the temperatures do drop down at night, it'll keep me warm as well. But this thing was just too much. So I have another one, a summer sleeping bag coming in the mail that will be much better in the summertime. It compacts down much smaller, it's much lighter, and yeah, in the winter I'll probably switch back to this if I have to, but for the summer it's just way too much. So the last things here I want to bring up are a few extra things I brought along on my last trip. They don't stay in my pack necessarily, but they were there for cooking purposes, and I said I would talk about them in my last video, so I'm going to do that now. Mostly what I'm talking about is these, and kind of talking about the pros and cons of each. So this is like $25, I think, total. Little canister, butane, and, you know, the thing that screws on top. So the other thing here, you pop it open and set it down, take one of the little squares from inside, and you pop it in there, you light it on fire, and it's a little portable stove. So my thoughts on these two items. This one is smaller, it is more compact, it is lighter. And those are all really important things when you're talking about getting home bags. This one is much easier to control. It's not a big noticeable flame. I don't know if that's a concern of yours. It it'll last a lot longer if you have a full tank. But it is heavier and a little bit bigger. So I don't know. I lean a little bit more towards this option. It's, like I said, much easier to control, which is just a huge plus, and it'll last a lot longer if 2 days turns into more days, and you just need to start worrying more about boiling water and cooking food. So, yeah, that's my thought on those items. So, I want to talk a little bit about my philosophy around my get home bag. I want to make it very clear that this is a get home bag and not a bug out bag. I think in the YouTube community, in the online community, I think bug out bags are probably a lot more popular of a topic, but I feel a much less likely scenario would come up in which you would need a bug out bag over a get home bag. I can think of several realistic scenarios where you need to get home and you don't have access to roadways or traditional means of getting home, and that's where a get home bag is extremely useful. If you keep it in the trunk of your car, it can come in handy. Let's say you know you're trying to get home and there was a natural disaster or a huge wreck, and there's just no getting out of where you are. You are stuck in just a 5 mile long parking lot essentially on the highway, and you need to get home. You know, you can't just live in your car for 3 days. You just need to get home. You need to make sure your family's okay, especially in the case of a natural disaster, and this is perfect for that. You know, let's say you live 25 miles away from where you work, and so you need to hike 25 miles to get home. With this pack, that's completely doable. Like I mentioned before, weight is a huge factor in that. You don't want a big, giant, bug-out style pack just to spend 2 days getting home. That's not necessary. That's just going to wear you down. It's going to slow you down. And it's just going to be cumbersome and difficult.